words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. Blessing us, strengthening us, and for keeping us. And we are so grateful to him that he has blessed us to come together one more time to offer to him sacrifices of praise. Amen. We thank God for you all who are here today. And we pray that this worship service will be a blessing to you, and that it will enhance your walk with the Lord. Yes. Two passages of scripture from Psalms number 51 and verse 17. Psalms 51, verse 17. There you find these words. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart. O God, thou wilt not despise. Psalms 34 and verse number 18. Psalms 34, verse 18. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and saveth such as be of a contrite spirit. Amen. And today, for a few moments, we just want to talk about brokenness. Brokenness. Anybody here ever been broken? If your life has been broken into many pieces, all you need to do is come to Jesus. Jesus knows what to do with the broken pieces of your life. He knows how to put you back together again. You heard the story, the nursery rhyme or whatever they call it, of Humpty Dumpty. It said Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's men and all the king's horsemen couldn't put Humpty back together again. Well, I want you to understand that there is a man. His name is Jesus. Jesus can put you back together again. And he can put you together so good that no one will even know that you ever been broken. being hurt, and we talked about being broken. And we find ourselves believing the saying that time heals all wounds. We believe that a few comforting words, a little sympathy, will make everything all right. And we don't understand that when people don't seem to bounce back from something the way we think they should, or as soon as we think they should, we believe that time should have healed their hurt by now. But what we fail to understand is that there's a difference between being hurt and being broken. And since we don't understand the difference between being hurt and being broken, we cast judgment on people and say things like, they just need to get saved. They just need to let it go. They just need to get over it. And we say these things because we never really understand the difference between being hurt and being broken. There are many people in our society today that are being incarcerated mentally. They're incarcerated physically and spiritually. Although they may be free from human judicial system and are regretfully imprisoned in a far more cruel and ultimately eternal prison. They are sentenced with a life sentence of emotional emasculation, depression, anxiety, low or no self-esteem, and they suffer from some phobias, and some are on the habitual death row of deadly narcotics, alcohol, careless, unsafe, and uninhibited sexual activity. Others have been placed in a solitary confinement of physical pain, discomfort, inescapable walls, being made to believe that this is all there is to life, mentally messed up, emotionally emasculated, spiritually lost. They are aimlessly wandering through a life that is busted, a life that is disgusted, a life that is broken. Their lives are shattered. Their dreams are non-existent. Their hope is gone. They are being battled by that angry sea of sin, tossed to and fro, bouncing from relationship to relationship, being dragged down through the gutter of degradation. Their self-respect has been broken. Their esteem has been broken. Their reputation has been broken. Their innocence has been broken. And now they find themselves disappointedly unable to see that God has a far more excellent and abundant life for them. They are struggling, trying to break free, and unable to come into the freedom that is promised to them. God has given us freedom. He has given us the liberty that He has planned for us. So guess what? They don't understand that the price for their freedom has already been paid. Because they don't understand, they don't realize that they don't have to remember. can be put back together again. They can have life, and they can have it more abundantly. And all they have to do is come. Let Jesus put the broken pieces of their life back together again. So then I got a question for you here. Is there anybody here ever been broken? Then you know the power of God. You